Before the ENS Name Wrapper, you could already create subnames underneath your ENS name. However, although your ETH second level name is an NFT, those subnames were not yet NFTs. The ENS Name Wrapper wraps any ENS name into a fully fledged ERC-1155 NFT. You can take your ETH name and turn it into a wrapped ERC-1155 NFT. Let's wrap one of our subnames. Now the subname is a wrapped ERC-1155 NFT too. Those lines you see represent so-called fuses for your wrapped ENS name, which apply certain perks or restrictions, like making the NFT non-transferable. The fuses connect from the parent name to the child name. As you can see, this subname is still anchored to its parent, and the parent owner has access to all fuses for the subname. The subname is wrapped, but it is not yet emancipated. The owner of the subname can still unwrap, rewrap, transfer, set the resolver, and even create its own subnames. However, the owner of the subname cannot burn any fuses yet. To emancipate a name, the parent can burn a special fuse called Parent Cannot Control. This subname is now in the emancipated state. The parent can no longer burn any fuses or affect this subname in any way. The owner still cannot burn any owner-controlled fuses or fuses of its own subnames yet. To do that, you must lock the name. To lock a name, burn the cannot unwrap fuse. This name is now locked, meaning that it can no longer be unwrapped. After locking a name, you can now gain access to burn other owner-controlled fuses and subname fuses as well. These steps can also be performed all in one fell swoop. In one transaction, the parent was able to emancipate and lock the subname, and at the same time, burn some additional fuses. For more information, see our documentation at docs.ens.domains. Thank you for watching.